Hey, what's up guys? Today I'm going to show you how to make a start menu in Scratch. This is the part 3, so let's get started. So today we're going to make this start menu. As you can see here, this is a very simple one. The previous one we made are a bit complex, but this is a very simple one. This works like there's the title, there's a scenery, and press F to play or press any P to play and anything. This is just very simple. When you have press F, it will just hide. So we're gonna just make like the background, the button like this thing. It will just fade in and fade out every second. And you can just make it. It's very simple. So let's get started. First of all, what we're gonna do is when the green flag click, broadcast green flag. We just do it for safety if you make like a big game. So this is required. And after that, when I receive green flag, just hide. So we're gonna work with clones for this. So we'll make a block called build. Number input, start input, run without screen refresh should be checked, click on OK and make it. So now we're gonna make a variable called clone number for this sprite only, click on OK, make it hidden. So now set clone number to start. Why we are making this, I will tell you after the script is made. So repeat number times, create clone of myself, and also just put here change clone number by 1. So how this works, like we are making us clones in sequence, like first the background will be made, then the button and things. So we don't have any button, but the press F to play will be a different clone. So we are working only with clones, and this is the way to make it. First of all, this is our anchor variable, you can say clone number. So it will just set clone number to 0, like if we put here this, and we are building two things, the background and the press F to play. So 2 and start from 0. Start is always from 0, but if you want to have a break in between, so it just sets the clone number to start, like which is 0 here. Then it repeats the number times we put here. So it is making the number of clones we wanted to make. Then change clone number by 1. It is 0 here, and then it is set to 1. And set like it is changed to 1. So when it is 1 and creates clone of itself. So when the clone is created, it has the value of 1. So like we can just do it like when I start as a clone, if clone number is equal to 1. So it will just get it immediately as it is made. And you can just get into the script if it is 1. Like switch to costume background. So it is just get into that. But if you duplicate this and put it 2 here. And when the second time it repeats, like change clone number by 1. So it is now 2. And when the clone is created, so it will just go like if clone number is equal to 2, then it will go into this. As it is never 1 when it is created. So this will work very perfectly. You can watch my video on my algorithm for making Scratch games to know more about this. So when I start as a clone, first of all, switch to costume background. We don't need any script for background anymore. So duplicate this. If clone number is equal to 2, switch to costume play. So you need these two costumes, like one is the layout. Then we have the background like this. It should be in this white box you can see here. And then we have press F to play. I have made this, you can just make it, it's easy. And you can just now go to the script and switch to costume play. So it will be press F to play. So we need to detect press F to play. So here we'll put wait until key F press and then broadcast start. So start will start the game and just delete the menu. So to just make that animation, like if you now start the game, it will not show anything. Because we have not made these visible, so go to front layer and show should be done here. So now when you click here, like here you can see we have that screen, press F to play. When you press F, the game doesn't delete anything as we have not made script for that, but this is working and this will start the game. So to first of all make the animation, you can just make another script like when I start as a clone, if clone number is equal to 2, duplicate this from here. So it a single clone can have multiple scripts using this. So you can just get in both the scripts when the clone is made. And now forever, clear graphic weights. First of all, we'll put above it. And also you can just put it inside of that too. Set ghost effect to say 100. And then repeat 20 times. Change ghost effect by minus 5. So it will just decrease the ghost effect by 5. 20 times, so it will be now 0. And then we'll wait for a 0.5 second or 1 second if you want. I'll wait for 0.5 seconds. Then you can just duplicate the script and put here. Set ghost effect here to 0. Then repeat 20, change goes back by 5. So it will just go to 100. So our text will be fading away. And then it will wait for 0.5 seconds. And you can also remove this clear graphic effect if you want. If you have not applied any other effects. And now this should work. So let's see. So as you can see here, the animation is playing here. And this is very good. You can just customize it as you want. You can increase the delay. You can add different effects like brightness effects to change the color or things. No color effect. And now we'll make the deleting of the menu. So for deleting the menu, you can make a variable called delete all clones with a question mark. For this sprite only, click on OK and make it hidden. So what this will do, like when we set this delete all clones to 1, all clones will detect it and delete it themselves. And after that, we'll set it to 0. So newly made clones won't delete themselves immediately when they are created. So we'll put a delay between them and we'll make it like this. This is the short script and this should happen when the game starts. So when the F key press broadcast start and when I receive start, just delete all clones. So to make them being detected in the clones, you can just go like when I start as a clone forever. If it's easy, like it's just delete all clones is equal to 1 and then delete this clone. This is that easy. So now you can just see like when we start the game, it is not made as the delete all clones is 1 when I receive start. So we can just put here, duplicate this and put here when delete all clones to 0. Set delete all clones to 0. So it is not 1 when we start. So now you can see this is now visible. When we press F, the menu is deleted and the game will start. To implement this in your game, you can just make it like, if you are having your game like starting at when the green flag click, do the following actions. You can instant just put like, let me show you a script. This is a simple script. If you have a script like this, you can just remove the green, when the green flag clicked and instant put here when I receive start. So your entire game in all scripts. So your entire game will be dependent on this start, start broadcast, and it will start when the F key is pressed. So this will make your game start on that menu and there will be no glitches. And you can also put everywhere like when I receive green flag, hide. So everything is hidden when the green flag is clicked. So the menu can show up on the screen. So this was all for this tutorial. This was a pretty simple one. And thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Hope you enjoyed this video. Comment down any links of this scratch menus. So I will tell you how to make them. And next part is coming soon. So thank you.